Hi, this is discrete section 4.4. We're doing graphs with vertices and edges, and we want to start looking at if we can traverse a graph and how can we traverse it without covering edges more than once. And so with this, I want you to warm up. I want you to try these first couple up to here before you listen any more to this video. It just is more fun that way. So stop, pause, and go ahead and see if you can trace this figure without lifting up your pencil or pen. And note where you started and stopped if you were able to complete this without doing this. I remember doing this when I was in fourth grade. Some of you have done it before. Try it. So there's a few different ways to do this, but the way that I remember doing it when I was in, I probably did in sixth grade, was to start here. There's other ways too, but that's one way to do it. Now, if you notice, I labeled these out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So that's the way you do it. Now, if you notice, if you were able to complete it, I'm going to guarantee, if you did it properly, everyone who did it started here and finished here, or started here and finished here. Regardless, they started at D and E or finished at D and E. That's the only way you can traverse this, cover it, in other words. Okay? So what happens is that we want to look then at the degree of each one of these vertices. So some of you have already done this. The degree of this one has three segments coming into it. So we label it with a three, this one as well. This one, C, has 1, 2, 3, 4 segments coming into it. So we call the degree 4. Some other books call it a valence. That one could be a 2 if you consider that a vertex, which we do. And then this one, 1, 2, 3, 4. We would have 4 there. Now, if you notice D and E, what's different about D and E as compared to the other ones? Well, I hope you can realize that D and E are odd. So if we start and stop at the same spot and cover this, what we call a path, those start and stop spots will be the odd degreed vertices. So how many odd degree vertices can you have if those are the only ones you start and stop at? Well, yes, to get an Euler path, you can only have 2 odd degreed vertices. The rest would have to be even. Why is that? Well, if you look at B, what happens with B, if I don't start and stop there, I go to B and I have to leave away from B. And then I come back later to B and then I have to go away from B. If I don't stop there, that's what has to happen. So you go there, go away. That makes two vertices. I'm sorry, two segments, two edges that are coming out of it. So that would put 2 into the degree. So anytime we have an even number, we're going to go to that place and then leave it again. With these, since they're odd, once I go to those places at a certain point in time, I can't leave because it has an odd degree number of segments with it. Okay, so now let's get into some definitions. Euler path. A sequential path that covers each edge of the graph, no skipping. And so that's what we just did. We started and stopped at different places, and so that would be more of a path than a circuit. Now, with an Euler circuit, that means that we cover each edge and then we start and stop at the same vertex. So that's kind of the difference between the circuit and the path. The degree is the number of edges that come into a vertex, or you could say going out, just how many edges are there. A digraph is a directional graph. That's where we're going to have arrows on each one of these edges. We'll show you that later. Now, here's some summary that I just did. For an Euler path, you can complete an Euler path if you have exactly 2 odd degreed vertices. Not anymore. It's got to be exactly 2. Now, I have some blanks on the pages, so you got to write this in. The path will start at one of these vertices and end at the other. That's what happens, and just by my previous explanation. Now, see if you can do an Euler circuit on this one, where you start and stop at the same place. Pause this and give it a go. Did you try it? I hope so. Okay, so what happens now is that if I label the degree of these vertices, I'm going to have all even. When I have all even, then I'm going to be able to do the Euler circuit, because whenever I start with someplace, I can go visit someplace else, but then I'm going to leave it. And then I need to come back where I started from, and so that would be even. So this one would be similar to the one that I did before. So I could do this. And do that, and then come up and clean that up. And so where did I start? I started right there. Where did I finish? I finished right there. So if you have all even degreed vertices, then you can complete the circuit. Circuit means that you complete the path fully. And so you go back to where you started from. Okay? So then, what is the degree of each vertex? We did this. So to complete the Euler circuit, all the vertices have to be even degreed. It is a path that starts and stops at the same place. And you can find an Euler circuit if you make connected mini circuits. So this will come up a little bit in your homework, and they'll explain it how to do it. But then you can look at page 193 for this algorithm. Moving on to the directed graph. With the directed graph, each edge has a direction. And each vertex has what we call an in degree and an out degree. And that's because we do have an arrow. So if I look at this figure right here, I can go to each one. I'm going to label in black all the in degrees. So if I look at this, this has an arrow coming into it. So that's going to be an in degree. So black will be in. Okay. So this one, how many does it have coming into it? Well, that would be two. How many coming into this? I see two. It's hard to tell there, but there are two. One coming down, one over. This one has 0 in degrees. This one has two. So that's all of the in degrees. Now, if I do this one with the purple, these will be the out. So from each vertex, how many of these arrows are shooting out from it? Well, this one would be one. This one would be one. This one has one. It's going that way, out degree. This one has, 3 out degrees, and then this one has 1 out degree. Okay? So now, to complete the path, can we complete this path or a circuit with this? Well, if you look at here, if I start here or if I ever end up here, I won't ever end up here. I can never get here unless if I start here. So right now, that probably tells you that we have a problem. So if I go here, I gotta go here. And I believe I'm done. I can't move anyplace else. So I can't complete this. I would never be able to get back here to complete all these other edges anyways. So what happens with this is that we have to match up in degree and out degree in order to complete the path. Does that make sense? So if I go into someplace, and I shouldn't say path, it should be the circuit. If I go to someplace, I have to leave it. So then the in degrees have to equal out degree. And if that happens at each vertex, then we have a circuit. We can complete a circuit. And so in degree equals the out degree at each vertice, or at each vertex, then we should have a circuit. Okay? In other words, each vertex must be in balance. That's the same thing. Okay? So in summary, a circuit is fully complete. You start and stop at the same place. A path covers all edges, but it may start and stop at different places. Then with the degrees of the vertex, you can tell if the graph is a circuit if all vertices are even degree. And then it's a path if you have exactly 2 odd degreed vertices. All right? And so then a digraph is your directed graph with arrows. That's all the digraph means. All right, it's just short for directional graph. Your homework then is section 4.4, and then these are the problems that I would like you to do. And so go ahead and do that and see if you can figure out these paths. It's quite fun tracing around and figuring out these things, but then they do have applications down the road. Thanks. Have a great day.